Hello everyone, this is Erlin from the Experience Research Lab. Today I'm going to show you how to transform a variable with visual binning. So visual binning refers to a process of creating a new variable by grouping the continuous values of the existing variables into a limited number of distinct categories. So that is to say that this procedure is only applicable to variables that have a scale or ordinal measure. For example, the number of employees, profit, and level of satisfaction. It is important to note that when you transform a variable with visual binning, it will copy the user missing values in the existing variable to the new variables. So for that reason, on this video, I will transform two variables altogether. The first variable is emp2 and the second one is emp2trans. Both these two variables, emp2 and emp2trans, refer to number of employees. They are numeric and use scale measure. The difference is that the first variable, emp2, has a long list of cases with missing values. It has 927 cases with missing values, while the second variable, emp2trans, doesn't have any. So to transform these two variables, I click transform and visual binning. On this box, I can see all variables that is applicable for visual binning. They are number of employees, emp2. This is the variable that has a lot of missing values, estimated profit to the industry, and number of employees transform, emp2trans. This is the variable that doesn't have any missing value. So I just select these two variables, click the arrow button to move them to the list of variables to bin. If I work with a large data size of 1 million cases, for example, I have the option to limit the number of cases scanned to 1,000 or less. But since my data has less than 2,000 cases, which is not too large, I can leave this box unticked and click continue instead. Consequently, the SPSS will display another window listing all the scan variables here. There are two, number of employees, EMP2, and number of employees transform, EMP2trans. For the first variable, EMP2, I need to create a name as EMP2_bin, and the label is automatically created by SPSS as number of employees bin. As you can see here, out of 1,822 cases, 927 have missing values. For the non-missing values, the minimum value is 1 and the maximum is 95. 1 to 95. So to transform this variable, I can either enter interval cut points manually or click make cut points here for automatic intervals. So I'll do the first option first by typing 15 for the first cut point, 30 for the second one, and then 45, 60, 75, and 90. So this is the cut points, 15, 30, 45, 60, 75, and 90. And if I click make labels, I can tell the first category is any value less than or equals 15. The second category is between 16 to 30. Third one is 31 to 45, and then 46 to 60, 61 to 75, and then 76 to 90, and the last one is anything more than 91. So what if I click make cut points? If I click make cut points, I will be given three options. Equal width intervals, equal percentile based on scan cases, and cut points at mean and selected standard deviation based on scanned cases. So for the first option, I'll put the first cut point at 15 with 5 cut points, and SPSS will automatically determine the width intervals as 16, and therefore the last cut point location will be at 79. If I click apply, the existing cut points definition will be replaced. I click OK. And this is the new locations of cut points. The first one is 15, and then 31, 47, 63, and 79. And again, if I click make labels, the first category will be any values equals less than or equals to 15, 16 to 31. The third category is 32 to 47. And then 48 to 63, 64 to 79, and anything more than 80. Now I click the make cut points again and go with the second option. I put the number of cut points as 5 as well, and click apply. And the new location of cut points will change to 1, 3, 6, 12, and 25. And if I click make labels, the first category will be any values less than or equals to 1, 2 to 3, 4 to 6, 7 to 12, 13 to 25, and anything more than 26. Click make cut points again and go with the cut points at mean and selected standard deviation based on scanned cases. For more information about mean and standard deviation, you can check on the other video on how to read descriptive statistics. And now I'll tick this first box, one standard deviation from the mean, and click apply. So this is the first cut points. One standard deviation from the to the left is minus 3.522. The second cut point is at 13.13. This is actually the mean. And one standard deviation to the right is 29.781. If I click make labels, there will be four categories. The first one will be any values less than or equals to minus 3.52. The second category will be minus 3.51 to 13.13. The third category will be 13.14 to 29.78. And the last category will be any values more than 29.79. So for this example, I'll go back to make cut points and select equal width intervals. The first cut point is 15, and the number of cut points is 5, and click apply. First category is any value is less than or equals to 15. Second category will be 16 to 31, third category 32 to 47, fourth category 48 to 63, fifth category will be 64 to 79, and the last category will be more than 80. I won't click OK here because I need to work on the second variable, EMP2 trans, and for this variable, I'll give a name as EMP2 trans underscore bin. As you can see here, there's no missing value for this variable, and the minimum is 1 and the maximum is 95. To show you the difference between these two variables, I'll jump into making cut points and go with the first option, equal width intervals, where the first cut point is at 15, And the number of cut points is 5 as well. And click apply. Click make labels. And this is the new category. The first category is any value less than or equals to 15, 16 to 31, 32 to 47, 48 to 63, 64 to 79, and anything more than 80. Now I'm good to go and click OK. And SPSS will tell me that binning specification will create two variables. This is what I want. And therefore I click OK. On my data view, I can see now that I have six variables: EMP2 industry profit, EMP2 trans, EMP2 bin, and EMP2 trans bin. And if you compare these two variables, these two new variables, you can see that EMP2 bin still has missing values all the way up to case number 9 to 7. While the first get the other new variable, EMP2 trans bin, doesn't have any missing value because the existing variable doesn't have any either. While for all other case values, are the same. One for, if I go to variable view, one is for any values less than or equals to 15, 2 is 16 to 31, 3 is 32 to 47, 4 is 48 to 63, 5 for 64 to 79, and the last one, 6, is for more than 80. I click cancel here and go back to data view. So that's how you transform variables with visual bindings. For more information into data, data entry, data transformation, and data analysis, especially in SPSS, please subscribe, listen, and watch more. All content by Experience Research Lab is available in text, audio, or video format. Thank you for being with me today, and see you next time on the next video. Cheers!